In this episode of Real Chemistry, we're going to be working on a partial pressures practice problem. So if you haven't yet watched my video on Introduction to Partial Pressures, go ahead and check that out first. So the question we're going to try to answer in this video asks, if 4.1 grams of liquid nitrogen is added to a 2-liter box containing oxygen at a pressure of 1.3 atm, what is the new pressure after the liquid nitrogen is allowed to evaporate if the temperature is 295 Kelvin? So there's a lot going on there in that problem, and we're going to unpack it piece by piece and show you how to solve it. One key thing to get here is that what's going on is we're adding liquid nitrogen. So that's N2 that's in the liquid phase, and it's going to N2 in the gas phase. So it's evaporating. It's going from a liquid to a gas, and that's going to add pressure to our box. So we have a box that contains just oxygen initially. We add some liquid nitrogen to it, and when that evaporates, that's going to increase the pressure. And what we're trying to figure out in this problem is, what's that new pressure? So let's take a look, first of all, at all of the different variables we're given and the unknowns we're trying to find, and let's start to try to solve this problem. So first, we see right off the bat that we're given the mass of liquid nitrogen, 4.1 grams. And so I'm going to write down that the mass of our liquid nitrogen is 4.1 grams. One thing you should keep in mind whenever you're doing partial pressure problems is, if you ever see mass, it's really the same as moles. We can go straight from mass to moles, no problem. Similarly, if the question asks for mass, it's really asking for moles. We can just get moles and then go to mass. So mass and moles are sort of really easily interchangeable. And so just to remind myself of that, in parentheses over here, I'm going to put N for moles and then N2 below. So we really have moles of N2 also. Now, what other information are we given about this box? It tells us that the volume is 2 liters. So I'm going to write down that the volume is 2 liters. And it tells us that it contains oxygen, and that this oxygen is at a pressure of 1.3 atm. So what does that variable represent? This is a little tricky, but remember, before we add the nitrogen, there's 1.3 atm's of pressure from oxygen. After that nitrogen evaporates, the contribution from oxygen is not going to change. That's what partial pressure tells us. Just because we add other gases to it, the pressure from oxygen doesn't change. So that 1.3 atm is actually telling us about the partial pressure of oxygen. So I'm going to write that down as PO2. And the partial pressure from oxygen is 1.3 atm's. Now, what else does it give us? It also tells us the temperature. It tells us that the temperature is 295 Kelvin. And what is it asking for? Well, it wants to know the new total pressure, or PT. So it's looking for the pressure total. That's what we're trying to find out. So let's take a look at our equations and see what we can figure out. Our top equation has pressure total in it, so that's a good thing, a good sign. So we know we want to find this. We don't have it yet. And this PA plus BB plus PC, all that's saying is we can add together the partial pressures of all of our different oxygens, of all of our different gases, to get our total pressure. So in this case, we only have two gases. So we have PA, which we'll say is oxygen, and PB, which we'll say is nitrogen. And we don't have any PC or anything beyond that. If you had a third gas or a fourth gas, you'd just keep adding them. Now, we have the partial pressure of oxygen, but we don't have the partial pressure of nitrogen. So there's two unknowns in this top equation. We don't know the partial pressure of nitrogen, and we don't know the total pressure. So we can't yet use that equation. If we find the partial pressure of nitrogen, we can solve our problem. So I'm going to add that to our list of unknowns we'd like to find. We'd love to also know the partial pressure of nitrogen. If we can solve that, we can solve our problem. So how can we find the partial pressure of nitrogen? Well, let's take a look at our other equation. This guy tells us that if we have the partial pressure of a gas, we can figure out the moles of the gas and vice versa. And we're given the mass of nitrogen, which is interchangeable with our moles. So we're really given this guy right here. And we also know we have the temperature, and we always have the gas constant, and we're given the volume of our box. So from the moles of nitrogen, then, we can actually solve for the partial pressure of nitrogen. So what we're going to do to solve this problem is we're going to use the bottom equation to solve for the partial pressure of nitrogen, and then we're going to add that to the partial pressure of oxygen to get our new total pressure. Now, before we can use our ideal gas law, our ideal gas law is in terms of moles. So we have to take our mass of nitrogen in grams to moles. So I'll do that as the very first step. So we have 4.1 grams of nitrogen. And if I want to go to moles, all I need to do is divide by the molar mass of nitrogen, or N2. There's two nitrogens here. And that's 28.01 grams. And so when I take 4.1 grams and I divide it by 28.01, that's going to give me the number of moles of nitrogen I have, which turns out to be 0.146 moles of nitrogen. Okay, now I have moles, and I have everything in my ideal gas law equation, except for pressure. Let's write it down so we can see that clearly. We have the partial pressure of nitrogen times the volume is equal to the moles of nitrogen times R times T. And we have temperature, we have the gas constant, we now have the moles, and we have the volume. So if we want to solve for pressure, all we need to do is divide both sides by our V. And that cancels out our V. And that tells us that our partial pressure of nitrogen is just equal to our moles of nitrogen times RT over V. And now we just plug in those variables. And so our moles we just found was 0.146. Starting to run out of space here, let's do it right below it instead. So our moles are 0.146. And our gas constant is 0.082057. And our temperature in this case is 295 Kelvin. And our volume is 2 liters. And when I plug that into my calculator, I'm going to get out the partial pressure from nitrogen. And it turns out to be 1.77 atms. So that's my partial pressure from nitrogen that I just solved. So now I have this variable up here that was a question mark. And now I know that the partial pressure of nitrogen is 1.77 atms. And now when I go back to my equation where I used to have two unknowns, I now only have one. Now I know that my partial pressure of nitrogen is 1.77, and I also know my partial pressure of oxygen. So that means I have all the information I need to calculate my total pressure. I know that my pressure total is equal to the partial pressure of oxygen plus the partial pressure of nitrogen. And now I have both of those. The partial pressure of oxygen, which I already identified at the beginning, is 1.3. And the partial pressure of nitrogen, I just calculated to be 1.77. And when I add those together and take into account sig figs, I get my new total pressure of 3.1 atms. And that's my pressure total. So that is the new pressure inside my box. So what have I done here? Let's retrace. We were given a box with oxygen in it, and we added nitrogen to it. We let that liquid nitrogen evaporate and add pressure. So we calculated how much pressure would come from that nitrogen once evaporated using the ideal gas law. And then using Dalton's laws of partial pressure, we just added together the contributions from oxygen, 1.3 atm, and the contribution from nitrogen, 1.77 atm. And we got our new total pressure. So after that liquid nitrogen evaporates, we're going to have a pressure in our box of 3.1 atm. If you have any questions, please let me know below. Please subscribe to get updates about future chemistry videos. Thanks for watching Real Chemistry.